Hello children, in our today's video we are going to discuss about the preparation and properties of alkenes, which are the unsaturated hydrocarbons having the general formula of CnH2n. Now in the previous lesson we have done that the alkenes, the nomenclature part of alkenes and the isomerism, they show the chain, the position and the geometrical isomerism. In the preparation part, there are four types of preparation of alkenes. One is from alkynes, then alkyl halide. The third is from vicinal dihalides by the process of dehalogenation. And the fourth is known as from alcohols by the process of dehydration. Now let us do one by one about these. So in the first method, that is from the alkynes. So alkynes are triply bonded, and in order to convert into double bonded, we need to add H2. But when the addition of H2 is done in the presence of PD and carbon, that is partially deactivated pyridized charcoal, and the deactivation is done with the poison like sulfur compound or quinoline, then this is known as the Lindlar's catalyst. It is known by the name of Lindlar's catalyst. And the addition of hydrogen occurs in such a manner that it gives rise to the cis alkene. Cis alkene is obtained. But when the hydrogen is added on the triply bonded, that is the alkyne, in presence of sodium and liquid ammonia, then we get the alkene in the trans form. So for the obtaining the cis form of alkene, we need the presence of Lindlar's catalyst. But for obtaining the trans form of alkene, we need the presence of sodium in liquid ammonia. So this is the first method in which the hydrogen is added. Now in the second method, that is the dehydrohalogenation method, we require alkyl halide. Now in this part, the removal of a molecule of HX, that is hydrogen and halogen, takes place from the alkyl halide. But the reaction takes place in the presence of alcoholic KOH. Alcoholic KOH, that is the KOH which is mixed with the alcohol, followed with the heating. In this case, the elimination takes place for hydrogen from the beta carbon atom and the halogen from the alpha. So 1H and 1X are removed. And by the removal, that is this type, the mechanism part takes place. As soon as the HX is removed, an alkene is obtained. An alkene can be obtained, and since 1H and 1X are removed, so the process is known as dehydrohalogenation. The elimination takes place, and the process occurs in presence of alcoholic KOH followed with heating. So for halogens, now here the very important thing, for the ease of dehydrohalogenation of alkyl halide, and the nature of the halogen needed is, different halogens are iodide greater than bromide than chloride. But for the case of the alkyl halide for dehydrohalogenation, then it is 3 degree, then 2 degree, and then 1 degree. So ease of dehydrohalogenation follows the presence of iodine, then bromine, then chlorine as X. And for alkyl halide, it should be 3 degree, then 2 degree, and 1 degree. Here we can also take one example in which one important rule is followed, that is the Saitzoff's rule. Saitzoff's rule. This is based on the dehydrohalogenation process. Let us assume that we are having an alkyl halide. Let us take an example of 1-chlorobutane. Now, in case of 1-chlorobutane, if we are using the alcoholic KOH and followed with the heating, dehydrohalogenation takes place, alcoholic KOH followed with heating, and the product obtained is but1-ene. The product obtained here is but1-ene. But what will happen if we are having the 2-chlorobutane followed with alcoholic KOH? If we have taken the example of 2-chlorobutane, that is this one. So now the beta positions can be two different positions. It can be beta, it can also be beta. So the variety of products can be obtained. For example, we can get but1-ene as well as but2-ene. Both the products are possible in this case because two beta positions are there. So what has to be done in such a case? It is butadiene. And then the other case is butadiene. That is the double bond in the center. So in case of butadiene, what the Zaitsev rule says here? According to Zaitsev rule, when two alkenes are theoretically possible by dehydrohalogenation process, then it always favors the presence of highly substituted alkenes. So for example, in this case, the butadiene is more highly substituted alkene. That is having the more branching on both the sides of the double bonded carbon atom. So butadiene is approximately 80%, while butadiene is approximately 20%. So in this case, since both of these are possible, Zaitsev rule, according to Zaitsev rule, the one which is more substituted in nature is going to be the major product. Now coming to the other one, that is the third method. Now from vicinal dihalite, how the alkene is obtained, the two halogen atoms are attached to the two adjacent carbon atom. So when a vicinal dihalide is treated with zinc metal, it loses a molecule in the form of ZnX2 to form the alkene. And the process is known as dehalogenation. So let us take the example of 1,2-dichloroethane. 1,2-dichloroethane we have taken, then treating it with zinc, slightly heating is followed, then we get an alkene along with the removal of ZnBr2. So both the halogens are removed here, both the Br are removed in the form of ZnBr2. The process is known as dehalogenation. Now the fourth method of preparation is by using the acidic dehydration from alcohols. Now it is also an example of beta elimination, as the H is removed from the beta position. Removal of water molecule takes place in presence of concentrated H2SO4 followed with the heating. So the water is removed from one of the carbon, the OH part, and from the other, the H is removed. And as soon as the water is removed, the alkene can be obtained. So as the water is removed, so the process is known as dehydration, and it takes place in presence of acid. So it is known as acidic dehydration. And now coming to the physical properties, the first one, the first three members are gases, the next 14 liquid, and the higher one are solid. Ethene is a colorless gas with a faint sweet smell, while all the other alkenes are colorless, odorless, and insoluble in water. As we have done in case of alkanes, the regular increase in boiling point occurs with increase in size. As we know that in a case of a straight chain, as the molecular mass is increasing, the boiling point will also increase. And the same theory followed here also, that in case of isomeric alkenes, the one which is more branched is going to have the lesser boiling point as compared to the straight one, because the thing followed is surface area here also. Now, the other topic followed after the physical properties is the chemical properties. In case of chemical properties, the first main thing is, the very important point to be considered is, alkenes are rich source of loosely held pi electrons, due to which they show addition reaction in which the electrophile add on to the carbon-carbon double bond to form the addition product. That is why the alkenes usually results in showing the addition. Addition of hydrogen, addition of halogen, addition of water molecule, sulfuric acid. They easily goes on adding on it because there is a loosely held pi electron cloud over here. So let us take first example when addition of hydrogen takes place. When addition of H2 or dihydrogen takes place, alkene is converted into alkene. For example, if we have taken C2H4, adding hydrogen in the presence of catalysts such as nickel, platinum, or palladium, we get C2H6, that is ethane. Now, the addition of halogen, that is the halogenation reaction. In this case, when an alkene is treated with a halogen, that is bromine, in presence of CCl4, then we get the vicinal nature, that is the formation of 1,2-dibromoethane. And the most important thing about it, that the bromine, which is a red, orange reddish in color, get decolorized after the addition reaction. So this is also used as a test for unsaturation. a test for unsaturation. It can also be considered. So unsaturation can be detected by the change in color of bromine. Test for unsaturation. Now comes the other one, that is the addition of halogen halide, hydrogen halide, that is HX, HCl, HBr, HI. And the priority rule follows here is HI greater than HBr than HCl. As we have done the addition of hydrogen, the halogen, similar is the case with the hydrogen halide. If it is symmetrical in nature, then what will happen on one of the double bonded carbon atom H and on the other I will be add on. In this case, there is we are going to follow the two rules. These are Markovnikov's and anti-Markovnikov's rule. Especially they are applicable when we are talking about the unsymmetrical alkenes. So let us consider the first case, that is the Markovnikov rule. According to Markovnikov's rule, the negative part of the addendum goes to that carbon atom of the double bond, which is having less number of hydrogen atoms. Negative part of the addendum get attached to the carbon atom. Of which carbon atom? Carbon atom of alkene. That is that double bonded carbon, which possesses lesser number of hydrogen atoms. So let us take this example. In this case, out of these two carbon atoms, this one is having the less number of hydrogen atom. So the negative part of the addendum, the attacking reagent, the negative part of the addendum, the Br, will go to the carbon which is having lesser number, and the hydrogen will go on to that carbon which is having the more hydrogen. So among these doubly bonded carbon atom, we have to justify. So what we have getting the product is 2-bromopropane. Now let us follow how the mechanism takes place. But the most important thing to remember is, according to Markovnikov rule, the negative part of the addendum would get to that attached to that carbon atom which is having less number of hydrogen atom. Now coming to the mechanism part, HBr provides an electrophile H positive, which attacks to the double bond to form the carbocation. So let us see when H positive attacks on the double bonded structure. So the two possibilities are, either the 1-degree carbocation is formed or the 2-degree carbocation is formed, depending on the addition on which the carbon the hydrogen has been added. So we get two cases, the 1-degree carbocation, we all know that it is less stable, and 2-degree carbocation, which is more stable in nature. So related to the mechanism, the 2-degree carbocation is more stable than the 1-degree carbocation. Now the Br negative, which is formed during the addition of H positive forming of the carbocation part, the 2-degree carbocation is attacked by Br negative. The 2-degree is going to be more stable. The 2-degree is attacked by the Br negative ion, and resulting in the formation of the product. The carbocation B is attacked by Br negative ion. So what we get as the major product, we will be getting the CH3, CH, Br, and CH3, that is the 2-bromobutane. So now the next topic related to the addition of HX is anti-Markovnikov addition, also known as peroxide effect or the Kharash effect. Now this is anti-Markovnikov, that is totally, it is going to be the opposite nature. How the addition has taken place in Markovnikov, it is going to be anti of it, the opposite of it. In the case of Markovnikov, the negative part goes to that carbon atom which is less hydrogen out of these doubly bonded carbon. But in case of anti-Markovnikov, the negative is going to add on that carbon atom which is having the more number of hydrogen atom. But this reaction takes place in presence of peroxide, and its major product is 1-bromopropane, if we have taken propene, the unsymmetrical alkene. Now in this mechanism, the first part followed is homolysis, that is the equal cleavage part takes place. Homolysis of peroxide, resulting in formation of the free radical. So this type the homolysis takes place, forming the free radical, phenyl free radical along with CO2 in this reaction. So the phenyl free radical, we know that the free radical highly reactive in nature, the free radical reacts with HBr. Again, the homolysis takes place. Now this time for HBr, forming the benzene along with bromine free radical. Now the bromine free radical attacks on the propene. Again the homolysis same followed. Now in this case we will get 2° free radical as well as 1° free radical. We all know that the 2° free radical is more stable as compared to 1° free radical. So 1° is going to be less stable. So what happens now? The 2° free radical now again reacts with HBr followed with the homolysis process, forming 1-bromopropane along with the formation of bromine free radical. And similarly, the 1° free radical also reacts with HBr followed with homolysis, forming 2-bromopropane, which is going to be the minor product. So both the products are applicable, but the major product is going to be the that one, which is having negative part attached to that carbon atom, which is having more number of hydrogen atom. And the carbon atom we are considering here is for the doubly bonded carbon atom, that is those which are having the double bond in them. So this is the Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov mechanism. The peroxide effect is not observed in HCl and HI because in HCl the bond is stronger than HBr. So it is not cleaved by the free radical. And but in case of HI, the bond is weaker. And the iodine free radical, combined together forming the iodine molecule instead of adding to the double bond. So we can show the peroxide effect only for the case of HBr. Okay. Now this is about the addition of HX, both the mechanism, Markovnikov, anti-Markovnikov, very important terms, both of these. Now coming to the other part. After the anti-Markovnikov part, there comes the other thing, that is the addition of H2SO4. It also follows the Markovnikov rule. Now in this case, again, the negative part would go to that carbon atom, which is having the lesser number of hydrogen atom in case of the double bond. But for case of symmetrical alkene, it takes place in the same manner. One of the carbon will get H and the other will get the remaining part, that is the negative part. So the formation takes place as ethyl hydrogen sulfate. When sulfuric acid concentrated is added, we get ethyl hydrogen sulfate as the product. But what will happen if it is unsymmetrical in nature? The alkene is unsymmetrical. For example, the case of propene. Now, addition of concentrated sulfuric acid following the Markovnikov rule would result in giving us propyl hydrogen sulfate. So the addition of H2SO4 also follows the Markovnikov relation, that is negative part going to that carbon atom of the double bond having the lesser number of hydrogen atom. Now comes the other part, that is the addition of water. Now addition of water takes place in presence of concentrated sulfuric acid. Few drops of concentrated sulfuric acid are added over here. Now in this case, when water is added following the Markovnikov rule, the negative part again goes to that carbon atom which is having the lesser number. So in this case, we first find out the one which is having the lesser number of hydrogen atom, and also by the electropositive and electronegative nature we can also show. In case of water, we know that H and OH, the H is going to be positive and O is going to be negative, electronegative. So the addition takes place like this. The addition occurs in accordance to the Markovnikov's rule. Now it is the case of the isobutylene, or we can say it is 2-methyl. In the IUPAC, it is known as 2-methylpropene. So addition of water results in giving us tert butyl alcohol, the common name tert butyl alcohol, or we can say as 2-methyl 1,2,3-2-methyl propane 2-ol. Now the addition of water follows this. Coming to the other, the sixth important reaction, sixth is oxidation. Now there are two different conditions for the oxidation. If the oxidation takes place in presence of cold, dilute, neutral or alkaline KMnO4, the vicinal or 1,2-diol or 1,2-glycols are formed. The reaction is also known as hydroxylation. The reaction is known as hydroxylation, since during this process, two hydroxyl groups are added across the double bond. Here, it has to be mentioned that cold dilute aqueous solution of KMnO4 is also known by the name of Baer's reagent. And this reaction is very helpful in a test for the unsaturation also. So if we have taken ethene, added water, cold dilute aqueous KMnO4, then we get the glycol, ethane 1,2-diol. The product obtained is ethane 1,2-diol. Now, if we have taken butene and followed the same reaction, then again, what we will be getting here is, if we have taken the case of butene, then what we'll be getting the product as butane 2,3-diol. Now, this reaction is very important because during this reaction, the pink color of KMnO4 solution is discharged. So this reaction is also used as a test for unsaturation. Here it has to be mentioned as a test for unsaturation. Very important, a test for unsaturation. And it is given a very special name under this category. This is known as the Baer's test. That is why it helps in finding out that the unsaturation is there, the pink color has gone decolorized. Now, if the oxidation is done with the hot KMnO4 solution, hot KMnO4 is used, then the two cases which we can understood here is, first, when the alkene is terminal, that is the double bond is present at the end of the carbon chain. So the most simplest example is of ethene. If we have taken ethene and the use of hot KMnO4 is done over here, in case of presence of hot KMnO4 is done, this can be the acidic KMnO4 or acidic K2Cr2O7, there results in oxidation like this. So we can here also use the acidic KMnO4 or acidic K2Cr2O7. K2Cr2O7 can also be used here. So what will happen here? If the ethene is treated with this, then it results in formation of the formic acid, and the formic acid results in further going oxidation, giving rise to water and CO2. So water and CO2 are obtained. But some other cases of terminal alkene is propene. If propene is treated in the same manner, then it will be giving us the ethanoic acid and the methanoic acid. And methanoic acid again would convert into, is converted into CO2 and water. If we have taken the example of 2-methylpropene is taken and the same method is followed over here, what we are getting is propanone along with HCOOH, and this formic acid again gets dissociated into water and CO2. So with terminal alkene, one of the products is always going to be methanoic acid. One of them is always going to be methanoic acid or formic acid, which will further gives on oxidation the CO2 and water. So this has to be remembered each time that HCOOH is formed, which is going to be broken down into water and CO2 on further oxidation. But what will happen if we have taken the example of non-terminal alkenes? In case of non-terminal alkenes, the carboxylic acid or ketones or both are formed depending upon the nature of the alkene, that which type of alkene we have taken. So if we have taken the case of butene, the butene is taken and further the same process, that is KMnO4 H positive can be taken. In this case, the KMnO4 oblique H positive can also be considered. Then we will be getting ethanoic acid as the main product. The ethanoic acid, two parts ethanoic acids can be obtained. But two molecules of ethanoic acid can be obtained. But if we have taken the example of, this is butene, but if we have taken the example of pentene, following the same process, that is KMnO4 oblique H positive is taken over here, then we will be getting one as the propanoic acid and the other as the ethanoic acid. So this is about the oxidation part using the oxidizing agent, either the cold dilute aqueous KMnO4 or hot concentrated we are using the KMnO4, which is acidic KMnO4 or acidified K2Cr2O7 is taken. Then the products can be varied on the basis of the terminal alkene or the non-terminal alkene. Now coming to the other part, that is the ozonolysis. Ozonolysis is one of the very important part for the preparation of aldehydes and ketones. In case of ozonolysis, the two-step conversions of an alkene take place, in which first of all the ozonide is formed, but further the reductive cleavage of ozonide results in giving of the carbonyl compounds, and the overall process is known as ozonolysis. So let us see how the ozonolysis takes place. First of all, an alkene on addition of O3 gives out ozonide. The ozonide is a heart-shaped structure like this. We can draw it like heart-shaped structure, so it is easy to remember also. Then further the reductive cleavage takes place, and we will be getting the carbonyl compounds. The carbonyl compounds are obtained. Okay, these carbonyl compounds can be same or can be different depending on the nature of the alkene we have taken, whether symmetrical or unsymmetrical. Let us take the first example of propene and addition of O3. So how we are writing propene? It is CH3, CH double bond, CH2. In order to make it the things remember, we always use C double bond C, opening the bonds here. And on this side, it is having one H and one is CH3. So adding O3, the product obtained is, adding of O3, the product obtained is HCCH3, the ozonide obtained, OCHH, the form ozonide is obtained, and further the reductive cleavage takes place. We should know that the reductive cleavage takes place in presence of zinc and water. Okay, so in the presence of zinc and water, the bond get cleaved, and we will be getting HC double bond OCH3. What is it? It is ethanol. Along with it, we are going to get HC double bond O and H, which is methanol. So the two products are obtained. It can be same or different depending on the sides of the double bond. So now take the example of but1-ene. In case of but1-ene, this is but1-ene. Now, when but1-ene is shown, is drawn in such a manner that ozonolysis can be easily represented. So we will get a CH, and there it is C2H5. Adding O3 to it, we will get the ozonide. We will get the ozonide here, then H and C2H5. Now in presence of zinc and water, the cleavage takes place. This is a very important method to understand how the aldehydes and ketones can be formed using the ozonolysis. The product obtained are HCH double bond O plus HC double bond O C2H5. So one is the propanol and the other is the methanol. The propanol and methanol are obtained. Now taking the example of 2-methylpropene, let us do one more example, that is 2-methylpropene. So first of all, we will draw it. 2-methylpropene. This is 2-methylpropene. Now, drawing it so that the ozonolysis and ozonide formation can be easily understood, we will draw C double bond C. There are two H on it. And on the other case, there are two CH3. So you will be seeing now how the ketones can also be obtained from it. We will first draw the ozonide, removing the two central double bonds, CH3 and CH3. Following the the cleavage here, in the presence of zinc and water, the product obtained can be, now the two products obtained are HCH double bond O, which is the methanol, and the other is, in this case, it is ketone. So aldehyde and ketone both can be obtained now. So it all depends on the presence of these groups, which groups are attached on the double bonded carbons. Now coming to the last chemical property. The last chemical property is polymerization. Polymerization is a process in which large number of simple molecules combine together to form a big molecule. The simple molecules are known as monomers and the big molecule is known as polymer. So let us take a very simple example. When a large number of ethene molecules are taken, then large number of ethene results in formation of a polymer of ethene, which will be known as the polyethene. Polyethene is obtained. So the polyethene is obtained. But if we have taken the example of propene or propylene, we will write it here as propene. Then in the presence of high temperature pressure catalyst, it is going to form the polypropene. Polymers are a very important part of our life. They are used in the manufacture of plastic bags, excuse bottles, refrigerator dishes, toys. Refrigerator dishes are made from it, toys, pipes, radios, and TV also. The TV cabinets are obtained from it. Manufacture takes place. Now the polypropene is used in the manufacture of milk crates, plastic buckets, and other molded articles can be obtained from it. So excessive use of these things have become a part of our life. And this is a topic of very much concern for all of us nowadays. So in this video, we have done the 4 very important preparation and the 8 important, very important properties related to the alkenes part. So dear student, revise these topics thoroughly and try to do the back exercise related to it. Till then, goodbye. Stay safe, stay healthy.